Hello friends, myself Professor Jay Tandel from Mahatma Gandhi Engineering College. Today we discuss experiment number 3 of industrial instrumentation. The aim is to study the measurement of flow using the Venturi tube. A Venturi tube is used for flow measurement. So it must be fitted between the pipe in which the fluid is flowing. Generally, Venturi is used for the gas pressure, liquid pressure measurement, flow measurement. So these are some figure. You can see it's a bolted part which is fitted left and right side inside the pipes. You can see the cross section that will be little bit decrease up to the value, and it lightly increase after that side. So we are measure actually flow, but the concept is we are generating some pressure difference. And here is the two part between that. We can use a manometer, another in which the pressure difference through which the mercury or other liquids are to be, its head is to be changed. So that the change in the head of the both this tube, that can be measured in terms of flow. So first of all, introductions. When the Venturi flow meter is placed in a pipe which carrying the fluid whose flow rate is to be measured, the pressure drop is occurs between the entrance and the throat of the Venturi meter. This pressure drop is measured using a differential pressure sensor, and when it's calibrated, this pressure drop become the measurement of the flow rate. As I told you, we are generating actually a pressure drop. We are making some cross section in such a way the pressure that will be differentiate, and pressure differentiate, so manometer and other types of pressure measurement devices through which the liquid level on that U-tube type manometer is to be changed, and difference between that pressure that can be calibrated in terms of flow. So flow meter broadly classified into two, that is volume flow rate and mass flow rate. We are not concentrated on mass flow rate, we are only focused on the volume flow rate. So volume flow rate, that is further classified into flow, differential type, displacement type, variable area type, and intrinsial meter. So in the differential type, there are orifice plate, Venturi tube, pilot tube, doll tube, flow nozzle. Here is a Venturi area, that is rotameter, turbine meter. So in GTU syllabus, that is this turbine meter, hot wire meter, rotameter, oscillating position in which rotameter and others are present, pilot tubes, Venturi tube, orifice fluid are the flow nozzle are the important exam point of view. So now what is the Venturi effect? Venturi effect is a reduction in fluid pressure that result when the fluid is flow through the concentric section, or we can say chalk of the pipe. The Venturi effect is named by the Giovanni Battista Venturi, which is 1946 to 1822, which is a Italian physicist. In a fluid dynamics, the fluid velocity must be increased as it passes through the constructions according with the principle of mass continuity, while its static pressure must be decreased in according with the principle of conservation of the mechanical energy. Thus, any gain in the kinetic energy, the fluid may be accurate due to its increased velocity through the constructions, is balanced by the drop in pressure. Now here is some cross section. You can see simply there is an inlet valve, that is outlet part, between that this Venturi is present. This cross section is reduced, so internally side it call as a converging section, and after the throttle of the cylindrical it call as a diverging section. Now you can see the cross section of the pipe is different, here cross section is different, here is cross section is different. So we can know cross section is to be decreased, then the flow that will be increased, pressure that will be increased. So that can be measured by this two. It may be upper side, it may be bottom side. So you suppose we have a U-tube type manometer over here, and in which suppose some liquid like mercury are present. When the flow is present, this due to the pressure that will be higher compared to here. So pressure difference that will be give some head difference of this work mercury. So that can be calibrated, that pressure drop is higher if the flow is higher. If the flow is less, then pressure difference is less. So that we can actually measure the flow with the help of pressure, that is called as venturi. Now here is some pressure difference. As I told you before, here is the cross section is higher, so A1 V1 and a pressure P1 at the point of 1 is different than the point of 2. You can see there is a higher difference and this is a lower difference. So between that, H plus delta H, rate of change of heights. So delta H that is considered over here, that is actual cross section to shorter cross section. So this thing that can be give the fluid pressure results. So here is the inlet, here is the outlet. See the cross section. Now have some animated video. You can see these are 3 meters that can be changed according to the change in the pressure. Here is the pressure that will be increased sometime, but it is not increased up to the level of this. There is more variation that will be over here, because the cross section over here that is very small compared to other. Advantage is less chances of getting a close with sediment, coefficient of the discharge is high, its behavior can be predicted perfectly, can be installed vertically, horizontally and or inclined. Low pressure drop, actually it is we are dropping the pressure for measuring the flow, but we are not drop the pressure up below the or up to the, we can say 10%. So lower sensitive to the installation effect than the orifice plate, that is the less susceptible to the damage, more suitable for glass gas flow with the entrance liquids. Now disadvantage is expensive, because this cross section is quite difficult to make, occupied the considerable space, cannot be altered for measuring the pressure beyond the minimum velocity. If the velocity of the flowing is very less, there is no pressure difference that will be generated. So if you want to measure the pressure, then the flow must be typically high. Now applications of the venturi meter, it is used where the high pressure is required. It can be used for measuring the flow rate of the water, gas, suspended solids, slurry, also oil, we can say, as well as the dirty liquid. Can be used for where the dirty liquids and slurry cannot be measured by the venturi tube. Cannot be measured by the orifice plate, sorry. It can be used to measure the high flow rate in pipe having a diameter in the flow meter. Thank you.